What's up, my Vena love, Sisters Vena D, coming to you all from Vena Tima News.
I promise you, I have other contents that have absolutely nothing to do with the Real Housewife of Atlanta that I'm getting together, that I'm going to post in a few days, because I know it's been just too much back to back, especially with Kenya Moore in the title, because that's my whole point. Who else on the show is doing something? Please do something so I can have a title that don't have Kenya Moore name in it. But I do have other videos coming up. It's just been a lot of Kenya back to back because I'm behind. And I mean, it's Sunday. The new episode will be out in a few hours. And I'm still talking about things that happened last week because I'm behind. But thank you all for your patience. I'm getting caught up. And I will post those other contents that have absolutely nothing to do with the housewife. Because I think at this point, most of you are like, yeah, we are over it. We're done. So, and I feel the same way as well. But I will do my review later. And I do have other content. Just wanted to put that out there.
Drew, Kenya makes all this fuss about being the first. Kenya never said she was the first. We all know she's not the first. If you're going to tweet about her, please don't lie. Kenya makes all this fuss about being the first Black Miss USA, but is quick to put another Black woman down and fix support. She tagged Portia in her Black Lives Matter movement. This person responded, "Babe, it's a reality show, not reality." Thank you. Kenya Moore does support Black women, and you know that. Thank you, Twitter. Every time you protest, there's a camera around. This is the most disrespectful thing someone can say to a Black woman who has sacrificed herself. You need to take a deep look into yourself if no one wants to come to an engagement party hosted by you. Responses. And how is this pushing the movement forward? Are you supporting another Black woman with this? And you will be a one and done season. If trying too hard was a person, Kenya ain't worried about you. Tweet about you not giving your husband sex on the regular. But we get it. You aren't relevant until you bring up Kenya Moore's name. Don't do this, Drew. Every new chick that comes on the show starts with Kenya to get a storyline. It's not cute. You're trying to reach. We know you want to start something with Kenya so you can get the attention. But starve because we can see what's happening. This is Twitter. So, Drew, everyone sees through you. We know Kenya Moore support Black women. We know the movement. And we know exactly what she meant when she said what she said about Portia. Black women don't tear each other down, Drew. It's just as bad as Kenya, or even worse. Being a bigger person means bringing peace to the situation, not pouring gas on it. Drew and Portia, she's returning the energy Portia has been giving her. You have nothing else to tweet about except Kenya? This reunion isn't going to end well for her. Like, she has to know Kenya isn't going to let this slide in anyway. Mind you, Kenya been paying her dust. The same way you're putting her down, right, Drew? Exactly, head up hot. Your obsession with Kenya is scary now. You need to stop, not your fight. Okay, you will be dragged at the reunion and you will not be asked to come back. Your life is boring. Portia has been shady towards Kenya since the last season. Like, every confessional was shady towards Kenya. And then when she got with Nene, she switched up on Kenya. But I guess everyone wants to be oblivious. Exactly. But she got a point about being around all those people. If you decide to start filming a show, you can't be out protesting in close proximity for days. Y'all need to stop using the movement in everything. So there you go. Twitter is not playing anymore. Instagram is not playing anymore. They see through all of these girls. They see through all of them. Kenya Moore even breed and she makes the news. Kenya Moore is trending. So let's jump on the Kenya Moore bandwagon.
Now let's get into Drew and her family and her thirst for Kenya Moore. Like, girl, go and please find the ocean your husband ran to. Don't go chasing. Your husband went to and quench your thirst for Kenya Moore, because in as much as I understand that, you know, everything that we are watching now is not live, still had a rough episode. Counseling session and, you know, your husband, father passing away, may his soul rest in peace, and just so much going on. And she had one tweet that she and her husband are doing good in the intimacy department, but almost every other tweet after that was about Kenya. Like, girl, focus on your storyline, what's going on. But we get it. Everything she's going through, we've seen before. We've seen the Kenny, Todd, and Mama George dynamic. Okay, we've seen it. We've seen Portia and her dude going to counseling. We've seen it. We've seen Kenya and Mark Dilley go back and forth, and other couples on this show goes back and forth. We've seen it. We've seen everything that Drew is doing right now. And we already know that people really don't care when she comes on the screen, because I know she's brand new. But people are already sick of the storyline because we've seen it before. You know what I'm saying? So basically, Drew is like, let me do what everybody else does because it works. Go after Kenya Moore. But what's happening now when I read these comments and tweets, there's a shift happening. People see what's going on. People now see through it, and they're no longer falling for it. You know, before people would fall for it and drag Kenya, now they're not falling for it anymore because they now do see that when you come for her, you pop. So people are sick and tired of it. Another thing, Cynthia Bailey gets along with everyone on the show currently because that girl over there is no longer there. So just because Kenya Moore doesn't get along with somebody doesn't mean Cynthia Bailey Day should be affected because Kenya Moore doesn't rock with someone. So that's why Kenya said, listen, since Cynthia gets along with everybody, I want everybody here because this is about Cynthia and not about me. You see that? When you're doing something for somebody else and you are not being selfish, that's what you do. Okay, so for Drew to tweet this like, oh, you have to look deep down in yourself. No, that's what Kenya was doing. I want everybody there for Cynthia Bailey. It is not about me. It's bigger than me. And I do not want whatever issues we've had to stop people from coming to support Cynthia. So, hey, Kenya, go ahead and do the invite. Kenya could have done the invite. You don't show up. That's on you. Because you as an adult should be able to put your differences aside and say, I'm going to show up to support Cynthia. You see, that's what Kenya did. This whole situation, the movement and everything, it's bigger than me. So even though I might not be here for Portia, I'm still going to go because it's bigger than Portia and I. That's what Kenya Moore was doing. She saw the bigger picture. But the small-minded people saw Portia and saw her sister. And then, why you want to go to the event? You don't like Portia. The movement is bigger than Portia. It's bigger than her sister. What we're fighting for is bigger than anybody. The same thing Mark Dilley and other people said. We know that you're not here for that girl over there. And she said some disgusting things about you and your daughter. However, this charity event is bigger than the issue you have with her. So that's why we are inviting everybody, because it's bigger than you, right? So for Drew to still tweet this, I'm like, girl, you're just desperate at this point to have a moment, you know, with Kenya. Now, I also want to quickly address this since we're on this topic. I'm going to elaborate once I do my review, but I can already see it. You know, they're at the table. Kenya questioned Portia about not being able to give Portia the gift herself.
And I can already see, oh, that's why she wasn't invited. She couldn't just enjoy the engagement. It was Cynthia's surprise. Cynthia's going to cry a little bit and be surprised. She couldn't just allow Cynthia to have her day, her big day, the surprise and all of that. She had to bring up issues so that she and Portia can have issues. No, you have to understand, people, at the end of the day, this is a reality TV show. And they still need to do their job. So, hey, when will be the next time we all going to be at the table to have certain conversations? Probably not anytime soon. So I'm going to seize this moment to just be honest and say it would have been nice if I was there in person to present you with the gift that I brought you. Now, depending on how Portia responds, we shall see tonight, okay, if it goes in the negative a positive direction, and I will have more to say. But at the end of the day, it's a show. They're doing their job.
Let me quickly make this point about part one and part two videos that I dropped on last week's episode, okay? We already know this, but for the people who don't know this, okay, let me just put this out there. There is absolutely nothing wrong with rocking with someone and then calling them out on their BS. That's the reason why in almost every single video, when I'm talking about people coming for Kenya, what do I say? I'm not saying Kenya Moore is perfect. I'm not saying that she doesn't have flaws. I always say that so people are aware that in as much as I'm calling out what people are doing, I'm not saying Kenya is just here perfect and not doing anything, okay? So just because I'm calling Candy and Cynthia Billy out on their BS doesn't mean they were not or are not good to Kenya in some aspects. But it goes for anything in life. Friendships, relationships, marriages, your family, whatever. If your sister is your sister in your blood, but she's doing you wrong, you have the right to let her know that, hey, I don't like what you're doing. Your husband's, wife's, relationships, anything in life. So don't be like, oh, y'all was just praising Candy and Cynthia and saying, oh, y'all love their friendships and sisterhood and all of that, and now y'all dragging them. No, there is absolutely nothing wrong with putting people in their place or letting them know. That's why I also said in those videos, there's a difference between calling your friend out, putting her in her place, or being honest if she's wrong, and throwing her completely under the bus. There's a difference. In the way how you approach it and do it, there's a difference as well. And in this case, Cynthia Billy and Candy were throwing Kenya under the bus and not putting her in her place or addressing certain situations in a friendly manner. They were talking about her, throwing her under the bus in confessionals and things like that. So let's not get it twisted. But anyways, you know, all of the tweets and people coming for Drew and reading her aside, I wish them the best. And my condolences to the family and all of that. I'm wishing all of you the best and take care. The end of here, my final loves. Thank you all for your love and support. If you're not subscribed to the channel, go ahead and subscribe to the channel. Go ahead and leave this video a thumbs up. Also, turn on notifications so when I do post, you're aware that I posted. And I will see you all in the comment section. Remember to always have the God bless attitude, which is being positive at all times and seeing the good in every situation. Have a great day, guys. God bless.